we thank you for Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, that you hear and see and know everything there is that's going on, and even in our lives.
That's right.
Thank you, Father, for our Lord and Savior and Healer, the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Thank you for speaking through these lips of clay unto this people. Thank you for giving illumination to my mind and direction to my spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
If you want to go with me to Hebrews chapter 12, the book of Hebrews chapter 12. Let's just read verse 1. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. You and I are in a race. Amen?
Amen.
Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Who's in verse 2? Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. No matter what you and I face in life, we are always to look unto Jesus,
yes,
who is the author and the finisher of our faith.
That's right.
What you are believing for right now, whether it's spiritual, whether it's physical, financial, or you need a miracle in your life, or for someone else, your focus needs to be on Jesus and not the situation.
That's right.
The Bible, oh thank you, Lord, as long as you look to the situation, you're not looking to Him.
That's right.
As long as your attention is fixed on what you are facing right now, you're not looking unto Jesus.
That's right.
Jesus has your answer. And your answer can only come from Him. Get your eyes off of your surroundings.
Yes.
The devil wants you to look at your surroundings.
Yes, he does.
The devil wants you to look what has happened.
Right.
But Jesus, the Word of God says, look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith.
That's
amen?
Right. Amen.
Glory to God. If you are occupied with anything else other than Him, you won't see victory.
That's right.
But victory only comes through Jesus Christ. Be occupied with Jesus. Keep looking to Him. I know the things that we face is reaching out to get your attention. Look! Feel! Look what has happened! But Jesus is greater than what you see.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we see, if we want a miracle, the Bible tells us in Hebrews 12:2, looking unto Jesus, not your problem, not your circumstances, but Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. He is the author and the finisher of what you are believing God for.
That's right.
Amen. What you are believing God for, Jesus is the author and the finisher of that. As long as you and I's got we have our eyes on Him. Now you remember Peter when he was walking on the water. He said, walk. Jesus said, come, and Peter walked. Amen. Peter was walking on the water. His attention, Pam, was focused on Jesus. Ain't that right, John? His attention, Jesus said, come. Peter got out of the boat and was walking on the water to go to Jesus. He's walking. He's looking unto Jesus, 14th chapter of Matthew, till Peter got his eyes off Christ in front of him and began to see the waves and feel the wind. And so his focus was removed from Jesus. Instead of looking at Jesus, he began to look at other things that surrounded him. And he lost the miracle. Now, Jesus was there in the flesh to catch him while he sung. And just because Jesus was there in the flesh, the power of God was not going to work for Peter unless he believed, unless he focused on Jesus Christ.
Right.
Jesus had to catch him. The Bible says he called him. You and I, the only way that you and I are going to receive a miracle from the Lord is keep looking at Him.
That's right.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Listen to this. Faith does not look two ways.
That's right.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Faith only looks one way. Which way is that? Jesus.
Yes. That's right.
Because He is a miracle worker.
That's right.
Jesus Christ is your miracle worker.
Yes.
You can't look two ways and receive a miracle. You look one way, Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Looking unto Jesus, the author, He's the author and the finisher of what you are believing for.
That's Amen. Right.
So don't look the other way. Look to Him. Now look with me now at Numbers real quickly. Go to the Old Testament, to the book of Numbers. It is said here in the book of Numbers, chapter 21, they are to have the steadfast look, just as we are to have the steadfast look. Amen?
Amen.
Even in the Old Testament, for them to receive a miracle, they were to look steadfastly. Look at verse number 4. Of Numbers 21. And they journeyed from Mount Hor by the way of the Red Sea to compass the land of Edom. And the soul of the people was much discouraged because of the way. Now they're discouraged. Now we have to be careful when we get discouraged, because all of us in here, you have been discouraged, you might be discouraged, and you're going to get discouraged. Brother Dennis, why do you say that? Because you live in this world.
That's right.
But be careful in your discouragement. Amen?
Amen.
Look at verse 5. And the people spake against God. Don't speak against God. And against Moses or anyone else. Wherefore have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, neither is there any water, and our soul loatheth this light bread. In other words, they were tired of it. God was feeding these people.
Yes.
Those millions of people, He was feeding them, and they were getting tired of it. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people. And they bite the people, and much people of Israel died. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee, praying to the Lord that He take away the serpents from us." And Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole. And it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten..." How many of you know that we are bitten today with the things that we face?
Right.
Amen.
That's right.
Whether it's sicknesses, diseases, trials, tests, spiritually, physically, financially, emotionally, there's people that need a miracle in their mind for peace.
Right.
We need help for our bodies. How many people today are bitten by the devil?
Right.
So to speak.
Right.
Everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live. Now look at verse 8. And the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent, and set it upon a pole, and it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live." serpent of brass and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. Now let's stop right here and look at this true happening. These people sinned, they confessed it, they repented, they went to Moses. And then God comes on the scene, he tells Moses to make a serpent of brass. And everyone who looketh upon it shall live. Now he did not say glance.
Right. Amen. That's right.
Or worship.
Now the word looketh means a steadfast look. Or, if you look it up, a continued look. When you and I receive a miracle from Christ, it cannot be a glance.
Come on.
That's right.
It has to be the continued look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Peter glanced at Jesus and walked on the water.
That's right.
If Peter would have had the steadfast look, the continued look at Jesus, even though those waves were contrary in the wind, he would have walked to Jesus and walked back to the boat.
Amen. That's right.
These people, many of them died when these fiery serpents bit them. Now imagine the mindset of some of them in that day. They looked at it, but then they looked back at their symptoms. They died. It's the steadfast look. It's the continued look, Renee, Madison. It's that you and I have to look to Jesus steadfastly and continue looking at him.
That's right.
Not just a glance at Jesus. See, what got them in this situation was their complainings. Mm-hmm. They complained against God. They murmured against God. They complained against Moses. What they do, they spoke against God. They spoke against Moses. When you speak against someone, you're complaining. You're murmuring. And so, that is a deadly sin. And so God sent these fiery serpents to these Israelites that complained and spake against Moses. And then they said, we sinned. See, many people, when they think about sin, they're thinking about big things like murder. Or adultery, or fornication,
right.
Or lying, or stealing, you know, or robbing someone. But did you know that complaining?
That's right. Come on.
The Bible says we've sinned.
That's right.
Yeah,
complaining was so evil that God sent fiery serpents to wither them out, if you please. And when they recognized their sin, they repented, and then God came on the scene.
Amen.
Yes.
But the only one of those that were healed was those that looked steadfastly at that brazen serpent that was lifted up on a pole. When they looked at that brazen serpent with a continued look, they might have been dying. But as they looked past their circumstances, past what they were feeling in their body,
that's right.
When they looked at the brazen serpent, almost dead, as they looked, with a continued look, they begin to get stronger.
That's right.
Stronger.
Amen.
And stronger.
That's right.
You and I, in our situation that we face, you have to have the continued look unto Jesus,
yes.
Who is the author and the finisher,
yes.
Of your faith.
Amen.
That's right.
If they would not have looked steadfastly and went back to their symptoms, they would have died.
That's right.
The one that was dying here in this true happening in Numbers 21, looking at the serpent, and if he would begin to look back and feel, he would have lost out. The miraculous, the supernatural, has begun in many people's lives.
Yes.
God was working behind the scenes.
That's right.
And then they begin to look at something other than Jesus, the Word of God. And they were devoured. Look with me now, as we have read Numbers verse 21, and we see in verse 8, I'm going to read verse 8 one more time and 9, and then we're leaving. And the Lord said unto Moses, make thee a fiery serpent, and set it on a pole, and it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live. And Moses made a serpent of brass and put it upon a pole, and it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived. How did they live? They looked at the cure that God said, look at.
Right.
What is God saying to us today to look at? Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Jesus is a miracle worker. He can do anything.
That's right.
Well, somebody says, well, if God can do anything, won't he just help me? Faith has to be exercised.
That's right.
That's the way it is. That's the way that he's laid it down in the book.
That's right.
I wish it was easy that we could just ask and without faith and all receive. But you know, this world would be in a mess then.
That's right.
Amen. And let me share this with you. God is no respecter of persons.
That's right.
If all ask in faith, and the Bible says, let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. First chapter of James. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. Let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. He talks about wisdom there in the first chapter of James. But he went on to say, let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord if we don't ask in faith.
That's right.
You cannot look in two directions. You cannot look to Jesus and look back at your problem that you are facing. You have to keep looking at Jesus. Yes, they're real. Problems are real. Yes, they're very real. But Jesus can come in to this scene and change it.
Yes.
The Bible says we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen.
That's right.
And how do we do that, Missy? By faith.
That's right.
By faith. So these Israelites, and I'm going to share this with you because it just came to me like a flash. It took faith for these Israelites to look at something that God told Moses to put a fiery serpent of brass and lift it up. Now that took faith for them to do that. Many of those Israelites that died thinking that's foolish.
Right.
Many people today die thinking, well, that's foolish for me to look at Jesus. Did he die for me? Did he really die for me? I met people that I talked to that thought that was foolish that a man died for their sins. He's the only way to be saved, Billy Jones.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
There's no other way to be saved except through Jesus Christ.
That's right. Amen.
He is the author and the finisher of your faith. When your faith pleases him, bam, there's the answer.
That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes, you're going to be bitten. Maybe not by a fiery serpent, but you're going to be bitten by a trial.
That's right.
You're going to be bitten by a sickness or by a disease or by a situation.
That's right.
That is holding you right now. We all face trials. We all face difficulties.
That's right.
Who do we go to?
Jesus.
Man, you will be disappointed. To man and woman to pray. But don't put your faith in man. Put your faith in God.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Yes, God will use man. But put your faith in God.
That's right.
And so, those that looked upon it, they could have been deadly ill right at death's door. And when they looked, with a steadfast look, as God commanded, they lived. You and I are to look steadfastly at the Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Now look with me now at Psalms 91. Psalm chapter 91. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Look at verse 1. We're talking about looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. You need him in this life.
Yes.
That Everyone needs God.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And those that reject Him, if they only knew how good He was. Many people blame God for the things that happen in life when it was the devil that they should have been blaming.
Right.
Look at Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. How do you and I dwell in the secret place? By looking to Him.
Right.
I said you dwell in the secret place. You look to Him every day when you get up. When I got up this morning, I started quoting what I believed.
Yes, that's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Looking to God. Circumstances says no, but Jesus is a miracle worker over circumstances.
Yes, that's right.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He that dwelleth in the secret place. It didn't say he that comes and goes. He that dwells.
Yes.
In the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. How? By looking to Him.
That's right.
By worshiping Him. By offering up thanksgiving. By having the steadfast look unto God. He is my refuge. He is my fortress. He is my rock. He is my help. Yeah, but Brother Dennis, I don't feel like it. That's when you and I ought to look.
That's
yes,
right. Man. That's right.
A couple of weeks ago, I believe it was, John, I was getting ready. I believe to go to a tent revival, if I'm not mistaken. Or church here. Or come to church. And while I was getting ready, I started having some symptoms in my body. And the first thing I did, I started looking to Jesus.
All right.
Yeah.
I started looking to Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus, I resist these symptoms in Jesus' name. Yes. Jesus, looking unto Jesus. Had my mind on Him. Consider Him. Consider Jesus. Looking unto Jesus. And they vanished.
Yeah, that's right.
Praise God.
The more, thank you, Lord. Look at here. The more that you concentrate and dwell upon your symptoms, the bigger they will become.
That's Amen. Right.
The more real they will become.
That's right.
You know, Jonah was in the whale's belly. But he offered up thanksgiving to the Lord. And you know what he called his symptoms in the whale's belly? Lying vanities. He believed God over than his circumstance in the whale's belly.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah. That's faith, ain't it, faith?
Yes, it is. Mm.
He called them lying vanities. Was he in the whale's belly? Yes. But the whale took him where God told that whale to take him.
That's right.
And the whale spit him out.
Yeah, right.
And he preached the gospel. But while he was in his circumstance, while he was being tested, while he was in his trial, he offered up thanksgiving, and he called his symptoms lying vanities.
Yeah. All right. Amen.
And he trusted in who?
Jesus.
That's right. He trusted in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now look at verse 3 of Psalm 91. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
Yeah.
The noisome pestilence?
Come on.
See, walking by faith is walking in resistance.
Right.
That's the first time I've ever said that in my life that I can think of.
Amen.
That's a good word.
Yeah.
Walking in faith is walking in resistance.
Yes. That is good.
When you are attacked, you resist because you know who you serve and who you're looking unto.
Yes.
Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
You know who you're looking unto. He said here, surely he shall deliver thee. How does he deliver us? Looking unto him and resisting.
That's right.
What the devil offers. Verse 4. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. Why? Because you're looking unto him.
That's right.
Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness. Notice that. And for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Excuse me. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. How do you make it? By looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith.
That's right.
Let me share this with you this morning. Never allow your eyes to grow dim at looking at him.
Yes.
Amen, Sandy.
Yes.
You keep looking at Jesus, and victory's coming.
That's
because
right.
Victory is only found in him. Mm,
yeah.
Yes.
Look at verse 10. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. That's what we are to look to, the word of God.
That's right.
Yeah, but Brother Dennis, I'm having symptoms. Look to the word of God.
That's right.
The Israelites were having symptoms by the fiery serpents.
That's right.
But what were they to look to in their symptoms, Bill and Joe, Sandy?
Jesus.
To the brazen serpent.
That's right.
While they were having symptoms in their bodies, what was going on, they were to look at the brazen serpent that Moses set up on a pole.
That's right.
What are you and I to do when we're having symptoms? We are to look to the Word of God. Look unto Jesus,
yes.
The living Word. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God, and became flesh and dwelt among us.
Amen.
Yes.
For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways.
Yes.
They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone.
Yes.
Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder.
Yes.
The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Look at verse 14. Because he has set his love upon me.
Yeah.
Therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him. Look, I will be with him in trouble.
Yes.
He didn't say you would have no trouble. He said, I'll be with you look to it.
That's right.
I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Yes.
With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Yes.
That's what you and I are to look to.
That's right.
With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. You look to that word. A brother of mine I was talking to yesterday. He's been fighting. He's been resisting.
Yes.
The devil bit him. But he's looking unto Jesus.
Yeah.
I think he said he heard four times. He said, I was in a sleep and I heard four times. I believe it's four times. He says, I was sleeping and woke myself up out of the sleep, Renee. He said that he heard the devil say, why don't you just die? And you know what he said? While he was bitten, you know what he said? He was looking to Jesus and he says, I shall live and proclaim the works of Christ. But who was he looking to, Russell? Sister Cook, Gracie. He was looking unto Jesus. That's how he could say it. Looking unto Jesus, I shall live and proclaim the works of Christ in the name of Jesus. But he was in a deep sleep and heard four times, why don't you just die? The devil don't want someone here that proclaims the word of God.
That's right.
Jesus, we love you, Lord.
That's right.
Stand your ground and look to Jesus and you'll always win.
That's right.
You and I will never win if we just glance.
That's right.
And look back at our surroundings.
All right. That's right.
You will not win. You will sink. The Bible says, because he set his love upon me. I want to share this with you. Now, John and Missy, I'm going to use them this morning.
Okay.
When John met Missy, he just kept looking at her.
Boom.
Still does.
Still does. And what did John do? It wasn't just a glance. Hold on, y'all can see where I'm going here.
Andy.
It wasn't just a glance. John, it was a continued look, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What happened? He got Missy. What happens when you and I have the continued look at Jesus? Guess who we're getting?
That's right.
Amen.
Sandy, we're getting Jesus.
Yes, sir. Amen.
And when Jesus comes into your situation, there's going to be no more lack.
That's right. Ooh, tell
that.
Amen.
Yes. When they two became one, look how much stronger
That's
John
right.
is and Missy is.
That's Amen. Right.
And I want to end with this. I got this from an Indian. From India. And I heard him say how many gods they believe in. And it was a lot. And he's a follower of Jesus Christ now. But I heard him tell the story about the king in India. So he dressed up one day to go see his people. And he dressed up and he just walked around and he just saw how his people were living. And he was saddened how they were living. And so he goes back and he invites everyone to come to his house to get something out of his house, to be a blessing to his people. In other words, he wanted to give to them instead of take. He's a good king, wasn't he?
Yes. Amen.
Well, one comes, looks around his house, gets a gold cup, leaves. So one by one comes to this king's house and grabs something and leaves with it. Till finally there's this one lady that is there. She looks, she walks, she looks around. She comes back to the king. She says, I can have anything in this house that I want. He said, yes, mama. Anything you want in this house, you can have. So she walks around the palace, the castle, and looks. And again, she comes to the king. And she says, I can have anything in this house. He said, yes, mama. Anything in this house you can have. And she looked at him and she grabbed him. She says, I'll take you then.
Got it all then.
That's right.
She takes him. She's got all everything. She's got the house, the castle, what
everything
in it.
Amen.
But he said, everything in the house.
Right.
And she grabbed him. When you and I grab Jesus Christ,
ooh, yes.
looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, when you grab him, you got it all.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Woo.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is your answer.
Yes.
Yeah, but Brother Dennis, you don't know what I'm facing. He's got it.
That's right.
Victory's yours.
Yes.
Amen.
That's right.
Let's all stand in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes. Yes.